If you want to learn how to swing harder, if you want to learn how to swing your ass off, if you just want to learn how to play music better, there are only three simple things that you need to do on a regular basis. You need to listen to great players. You need to listen a lot. You need to be listening to a lot of music, and you need to learn those great players' music. Learn what they're playing, learn how they're playing it, and then you need to practice what you learn a bunch. So we're going to do all three of those things, starting with listening. And you don't have to listen to me. We should listen to people like this. That's Wynton Kelly. Maybe you want to listen to someone like this. That's the great Bill Evans, or maybe your cup of tea is more something like this. That, of course, is the great Oscar Peterson, and that's who we're going to be listening to today, who we're going to be learning from, and who we're going to practice. So, very excited today to play this with you. Again, if you want to follow along, you can download the PDF there in the description. That's yours to take home with you. And yeah, we're going to be learning two choruses of Oscar Peterson's solo on the tune Bag's Groove from his album Night Train. And we'll start off by doing number one here, our first task. And that's listening. Now, when you learn a new solo, you want to listen a ton, like hundreds of times. You really want to be listening to it every day as much as possible. So we have a bit of a truncated version of this today, but I do want to listen to it before we even touch our instrument. So let's listen to the first two choruses of Oscar's Super Swingin' Solo on Bag's Groove from Night Train. Let's check it out. I mean, it's like the perfect definition of a swingin' solo over a blues, isn't it? I mean, there's like all this amazing feel, right? That is, by the way, just impossible to notate. I tried my best, but notation doesn't really capture what Oscar is able to do here with the feel of his music in space and time. So just take all this notation with a grain of salt and really use your ears more than anything, not just with this today, but with learning any music. You know, it's audio, it's audible music, it's not visual. So always lean on your ears first. So there's all this great feel, there's this amazing note choices, this beautiful voice leading that's happening in the left hand and the right hand. And then there's like all this great syncopation here, this at the end that... I mean, all of that is just gold. So let's listen again. Listen for all these things. I'm going to start. I know this solo really well. I'm cheating a little bit, but I'm going to start kind of singing along a little bit. That's step two. We'll get there in a second, but just let's listen to a couple more times through here of the first two choruses of Night Train. Check it out. Face. Awesome. Again, step two will be singing it. Let's listen to it one more time. Don't touch your instrument yet. Just follow along, listen, try to internalize the solo. Then we're going to sing it, and then we're going to play it. Here we go. So I'm already on step two. So listening, internalizing is just so crucial for being able to actually learn this music and actually be able to swing along with Oscar Peterson. If you're reading it or if you're thinking about it too much, it's just not going to feel great. So spend as much time as you can, listening and internalizing the music before you even get to your instrument. Let's do step two here, learning the music. So we are going to start from the top again. I am going to start singing along. I know this solo very, very well. We actually transcribed it in the Open Studio Transcriber Club a few months ago, which was super fun. But I am going to start singing along. If you're just learning it, maybe listen a couple more times before you sing, or maybe try to follow along and just try to sing it if you feel like you know some of the phrasing already. But jumping in and singing it is such a great way for internalizing the swing. Again, it's like learning a foreign language, right? If I want to learn French, I can learn it from a book and read it, but it's not going to be the same as immersing myself with native speakers. And that's what we're doing here when we sing along with Oscar, when we play along with Oscar. We're really immersing ourselves in the music in a way that is so much more, first of all, it's more fun than just reading it, but it's also so much more effective than just reading it. So really commit here to internalizing the music by listening and singing along. Here we go, let's try it. And if you have a kind of a suspect singing voice, and you're maybe there's people in your house and you might be a little embarrassed, so just sing louder, all right? Let's try it again. You know, it's so great to, again, vocalize that, really start internalizing that sense of swing. It just makes you, even when you're not playing this solo, right? Even when you're improvising, it starts to come out in a way that is just super swinging. Let's do it again and have fun with it. If you're not tapping your toe and clapping along and singing along anyway with this, there might be something wrong medically. So you might check your pulse there. Let's try it again from the top. Ba-ba-ba-ba. Again, I have people living with me, and so I'm just going to own it here because I don't have the greatest singing voice either. But it doesn't matter. You know what I mean? We're getting in the spirit here. All right. One more time singing, and then we're actually going to get to our instruments. If you're already playing your instrument, stop and just enjoy this part of the process. Commit to this part of the process, realizing it that it's just as important as being at your instrument. Let's do it again. Ba 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 ba. Okay, let's actually play it now. I will unleash you on your instruments. This is great on piano and guitar because you can hit those bluesy double stops that Oscar plays. Let's go down to 80% and let's try to play it. I'm still probably going to sing along here. Let's do it. Maybe right hand only. Do it again at 80% here, 80%. Here we go. Might add in some left hand here, a little more. Still singing. Trying to match Oscar's phrasing, his articulation. The dynamics between his hands, super crucial. Notice how underneath his left hand is to his right hand. Like it's just a whisper. Again, just getting to know it here. Let's go up to 90. It's actually going to be easier to swing this the closer to actual tempo we get. Let's try it at 90%. Thank you. more time at 90. One more time at 90. Let's get it. You got it. Distractingly swinging. All right, let's try it again. 100% at tempo. Again, it's not too fast. It's not too technical, this one, so it should be doable here at 100%. Let's try it. Again, the dynamics. Notice how the... The right hand is so much louder than the left. Not that it's loud, loud. We want to copy Oscar's articulation. His dynamics, his phrasing. Do it again. How great does that feel? And again, made better because we've listened to it a bunch here. We've sang along with it. Let's try it again. This is how you learn to swing. Just playing along with really swinging players. Here we go. Let's do one more go at the whole thing and we'll call it a day. So this is just a little bit of a microcosm of how we would do this, how we want to get better, how we want to learn how to swing our ass off. This is it. Let's do it one more time. Just flowing here with Oscar. Here we go. Have fun. Can't go out like that. One more time. Here we go. Hey. So great. So still some work to do for me there to catch up to Oscar, but that is the good work right there. So you want to learn how to swing harder. You want to learn how to play better. Again, those three things: listen to great players, learn their music, and then practice. And again, please download the PDF if you want to follow along. It's right there in the description. Thanks, everybody. Until next time, happy practicing.